today we're gonna create some disintegration effects. Hey everybody, and welcome to my channel. For those of you who are watching me for your first time, I'm Emilio Takas and I post videos here on tutorials, filmmaking tips, gear reviews and much more. So if you're into this kind of stuff, consider subscribing to my channel and also ring the notification bell to receive notifications every time I post a new video. One of the most famous effects that you have probably seen created with Adobe Premiere Pro and After Effects, it's now available in Final Cut Pro 10. And I want to say a huge shout out to Pixel Film Studios for creating this plugin and also for sponsoring today's video. I'm going to show you how we can disintegrate titles, how we can create transitions with disintegration, and also how we can make ourselves disappear like I did in the beginning. Let's go now into Final Cut Pro 10 and create some disintegration effects. We are in the Final Cut Pro 10 interface, and the first disintegration effect that we are gonna create is gonna be a disintegration of a title. I have placed the footage that it's gonna be behind our title. I'm gonna press Ctrl T and insert the basic title. I'm gonna write Summer in Mountains. And I'm gonna change the font. See how it looks, adjust the size, and put it right here. Perfect. Now we will go into our titles and we're gonna select the Disintegrate tool by Pixel Film Studios. I'm gonna select the basic and bring it on top of my title. I'm gonna zoom in. Now we go to the effects panel. Here we have the camera controls where we can adjust how our camera is gonna be positioned. And here we have the particle controls. Now, I'm gonna select the sweeping type. As you can see, we can select left to right, right to left, top to bottom, bottom to top. For now, let's go left to right. Here we can have the number of particle layers. More number of layers, more detailed disintegration we're gonna have. Let's select two for now. Also on the gravity amount, let's make it go heavy on top and let's have a light turbulence as well. Also, as you can see on this plugin, we can play with custom luma source, and also it has the ability to have motion blur. Let's add a little bit of motion blur and we can invert the animation as well. Now, if we press the play button to see what we have created, we see that it disintegrates the whole footage, like the title and the footage behind it. So what we're gonna do is to select the disintegrate layer and the title layer. We're gonna right click and click on new compound clip. And now that we have a compound with our title and the disintegrate effect layer, we have a complete effect. Let's play to see. There we are. Now remember that if the effect is too fast, we can go again into the compound clip, select the disintegrate tool layer, go into the effects panel and adjust the delay speed of the effect. Let's go and see. Perfect. If we have, let's say, 28. And now as you can see, the disintegration now takes more time to take place. Now I'm going to show you how we can disintegrate ourselves or a subject out of a scene. Remember that in order to achieve this, you need to have two shots. One with the scene without our subject and one with the scene with our subject. Now stay tuned, because if you don't have these different shots to create the disintegration effect, right after this I'm going to show you how you can remove any object with a different plugin from Pixel Film Studios. As you can see now, I have the footage with me on top and the footage of the scene without me on the back of the footage. I'm gonna play and find the spot where I want the disintegration effect to take place. I'm gonna press B on my keyboard and with the left click, I'm gonna blade it. And now again, I'm gonna take the disintegrate tool. I'm gonna bring it on top and I'm gonna go into the effects panel. I'm gonna make the particle layers 2. I'm gonna go into gravity and I'm gonna make a very heavy gravity on for top. I'm gonna select the direction from bottom to top. Also, I'm gonna select a moderate turbulence. I'm gonna add a motion blur. I'm gonna select the disintegrate tool layer and my clip. I'm gonna right click and create a new compound clip. And let's play to see. As you can see now, we have the disintegration, but we have the disintegration of the whole scene. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna double click on the new compound layer. And I'm gonna select the disintegrate tool. I'm gonna go into the effects. I'm gonna type mask. I'm gonna drag the draw mask and put it on the disintegrate tool layer. And now I'm gonna start and mask myself on the scene. You don't need to be precise 100%, just a rough mask around it. And with the mask now, I'm gonna go into the inspector panel. I'm gonna take the feather on the left so we can create a little bit of a feather. And if we go back now that we have created the mask, we see that it looks more natural. We can mess with the settings to make it look more natural. So we're clicking again on the new compound clip. We can make the mask even more feather by bringing all the way to the left, and also make the gravity amount heavy. And the final result is gonna look like this. Also remember that we can change the particle size in the particle controls. So we can have small particle size, but also we can have bigger ones. And now I'm gonna show you how we can create transitions with a disintegration effect. It's super simple. We have our two footages here. We will go into the transition panel. And here we have the FCPX disintegration transitions. We can choose what we want, bottom to top, left to right, custom with Luma, top to bottom, right to left, and Luma footage. Let's say that we want to do a right to left. We're gonna place it between our clips. And let's check it out. Simple as that. Before continuing with the last disintegration effect that I'm gonna show you today, I wanna say that for those of you who wanna get the FCPX disintegrate tool from Pixel Film Studios, I have placed the link in the description of this video, and the first 500 people who are gonna use the coupon code EmilioPixel, they're gonna get 30% off the purchase. Also, this coupon is valid for the plugin that you're gonna see right now to remove elements. Let's go. Now we have a footage where I don't have two shots, so I only have myself with the scenery. And in order for the disintegration to work, as we said in the beginning, we need to have two shots, one only with the scenery and one with our subject. And to remove me, we're gonna use the Pro Patch 2 plugin from Pixel Film Studios. I have placed a link in the description of this video for this plugin as well. And with this plugin, we can remove objects. And to start, we're gonna create a new compound layer, and we're gonna go into titles and drag the Pro Patch 2 and bring it above our clip. With the Pro Patch 2 layer selected, we're gonna follow all the steps here. And step one is drag the patch area. So we're gonna adjust the size of the patch area. We're making sure that we're in the beginning of the clip and we're clicking track forward in the inspector panel. Then we select the step two to mask our patch area. And then we go to the track, the problem area. So we're masking ourselves or the subject, and we're track forward. And now that we have everything ready, we go into the step 4. We select the area. We can adjust the overall scale here in the inspector panel. And also we can go into the mask pads and increase the feather so we can have a more natural look. And as you can see, our subject is removed. And now that we have two sets, one without our subject and one with our subject, we can continue the same process as we did before for the DC degradation effect, and the final footage is gonna look like this. Boom! Our subject is disappeared. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, don't forget to hit the thumbs up as it helps a lot with this video. Also, if you have any questions, I'm waiting for them in the comment section down below. Don't forget to subscribe, more content like this one is about to come in the near future. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.